Welcome to another Odds HQ NHL betting preview video for Saturday, August 22nd. The first round is over. Time to put it in the history books. Time to put it behind us. And it's time to look forward now to the second round of the Stanley Cup playoffs beginning tonight. It's game one of the Western Conference semifinal series between the Dallas Stars and the Colorado Avalanche. We've got Colorado minus 160 favorites in game one, the total 5.5. In this one, Dallas Stars changing their stripes a little bit in game or in the series against the Calgary Flames that just ended. Think of Dallas, a low-scoring, tight-checking, defensive-minded hockey team. That wasn't Dallas against Calgary. They found their offense. They got their goal-scoring production up where they hope it would be, and it obviously wrapped up against Calgary in the decisive blowout fashion, a 7-3 win for the Dallas Stars. In game six of that series, Dallas scored 5 goals or more in half of those 6 games against Calgary. So they really got their offense going. And if you watch that Stars-Flames series, and obviously I watched pretty much every game of every series so far, at least some of them, or at least extended parts of every game and every series so far. But if you watch Dallas-Calgary head-to-head, that was a fast-paced, that was an up-and-down trade chances kind of series. And that is not usually, at least during the regular season, that's not the way the Dallas Stars played. But they didn't mind opening it up. They didn't mind having their defensemen, Haskinen, Lindell, Klingberg, jumping into the rush and joining in on the offense. That's something that they've employed quite a bit. And to be honest with you, I think Rick Bowness, the head coach of the Stars, who of course took over from the fired Jim Montgomery early in the season. Montgomery was more of a, we're going to sit back, play defense. And to be honest with you, Bowness has allowed the Dallas Stars to play a little bit more free-flowing, you know, up and down the ice type of hockey. And it certainly worked out for them in that regard against Calgary. But working out in that regard with that style of play against Calgary is one thing. Trying to duplicate that same style of play against Colorado and having it work out as successfully, that's a completely different animal. And I think the Stars, they might be lulled into a false sense of security here in game one that we can go toe-to-toe, up and down the ice, trade chances, push the pace against Colorado here in game one of this series tonight and have the same success and be more aggressive offensively just like we were against Calgary and still be able to have success and win games. I think they're going to try to play that way tonight in game one because of how well it worked against Calgary. But that doesn't mean it's going to work as well against Colorado. Why? Because Colorado is just going to beat Dallas probably more often than not in a firefight, an offensive, you know, fireworks display, so to speak. And we finally saw the Avalanche break through in the last 2 games of their series against Arizona. They were really robbed in game 3 by Darcy Kemper, the only game Arizona won in that series, and they had no business winning it because Darcy Kemper made almost 50 saves and stole the game for the Coyotes. But after that, the floodgates opened for the Avalanche. 14 goals in the last 2 games of that series against Arizona, 7-1 victories in both games, 7 goals in each game. Really, this team's scoring depth up front and with their forward groups amazing. Everybody knows Nate MacKinnon. Everybody knows Gabriel Landeskog. Everybody knows Mikko Rantanen. But we need to start talking about Nazem Kadri, who is on fire here in these playoffs. Incredible goals, points. He's racking them up game after game. In fact, I like Nazem Kadri anytime goal scorer tonight. In game one of this series. Let me see what you can find that at. If they're not adjusting this price on him yet, I don't know what they're doing. Well, they have a little, but still, plus 160 is a great price. Nazem Kadri has been right in the epicenter of everything Colorado's done offensively so far in these playoffs. So that's a prop I would look at. But it's not just Kadri. It's Andrei Burakovsky. It's Jonas Donskoy, Tyson Jost, JT Compher. I mean, this team's just gotten everybody chipping in, helping out offensively. And this is going to be a handful for the Dallas Stars, a Dallas team that didn't even play all that sturdy and strong defensively against Calgary, but they got away with it. They're not going to get away with it against Colorado. If they don't tighten up and if they fail to give the puck away less than they did against Calgary, they're going to pay the price. That puck's going to end up in the back of their net. And you've still got a goalie in Anton Khudobin. Although he's played fairly well, this is way more games in a row than he's used to playing. He's accustomed to playing a start here, a start there, and a backup role. But he's now in a situation where, you know, he's playing a lot more games and a lot more minutes than he's accustomed. And we're going to have to see if he's going to be able to keep on doing it. I think it's a situation where he might get weaker. He might get worse as the playoffs go on for the Dallas Stars in net. And now you're facing a juggernaut offensive team like the Colorado Avalanche. Stars allowed far too many high-quality chances in that series. And Calgary scored 3+ goals in 4 of the 6 games in that series. And now you're facing an even more dangerous, dynamic, explosive team. So I do worry about Dallas a little bit in terms of being able to contain the Avalanche. And we're seeing Dallas, you know, they had some overs in the series against Calgary. Everybody thought it would be low scoring, snoozer of a series. That game had some overs in it. Everybody thinks of Dallas, low scoring, trending to the under type of team. And that's been true of their play, especially in the regular season. But if you look at their results in the playoffs, dating back to the start of last year's playoffs and so far this year's playoffs combined, Dallas is actually a profitable winning 8-6 to the over in the postseason, excluding pushes. So 8 overs, 6 unders, excluding throwing out all the pushes in the playoffs last year and this year combined. So they've actually opened up a bit. Obviously, the quality of competition goes up, and maybe their defense is not quite as good against those better opponents, better offensive teams that you usually have to go up against in the playoffs. So that kind of speaks to why Dallas 8-6 to the over in the playoffs. And I like the over in game one tonight. It's a nice plus price, +110, +115 with Dallas, Colorado over 5.5 here in game one. I think it's worth a bet. I think Dallas, at least for game one, is going to think, you know what, we got the pace going. We were aggressive offensively against Calgary. We got our offense rolling. We can play that way against Colorado. Well, they're going to find out if they play that way and open up against Colorado. Colorado's going to burn them. I don't care how good Dallas is defensively usually. Colorado will burn Dallas playing a more up-and-down style of game. So I think we get a looser game in game one. I think Dallas, too, off the turnaround Thursday night to a Saturday night game and a new series means they're going to be prone to more defensive lapses, turnovers, miscues with the puck, and that could fuel the offense for Colorado. I definitely lean Avalanche in the game from a side perspective, but obviously I don't want to lay -160, but definitely it would be Colorado or pass from a side perspective. But I'm going to stick with the total here. Let's go over 5.5. +110 with Dallas, Colorado, game one. That's going to be my Odds HQ NHL betting preview video best bet for Saturday, August 22nd. I'm Ian Cameron. Thanks for watching. As always, check out odds.com every day for great content and the Odds HQ YouTube channel daily for great sports betting, live shows, and videos. I'll be back with you tomorrow on Sunday for another NHL betting preview video best bet.